Wally Zhang created a potential watershed moment for the UFC and MMA on Saturday when she became the first fighter from China to hold the UFC championship belt, defeating Jessica Andrade by TKO in just 42 seconds in the UFC on ESPN plus 15 headliner in Shenzhen, China. Just a masterclass performance from Zhang in this fight. She did exactly what she needed to do against a very aggressive fighter like Andrade, found the opening for her counter, and it didn't take long. Finishes the fight very, very quickly. The second fastest stoppage in a UFC strawweight bout, and now it remains to be seen how deeply the impact of this victory runs. The UFC feels like this could open all kinds of doors for them in China in terms of gaining popularity, notoriety for the sport. Of course, more than 1.3 billion people living in that country. It's going to be very, very interesting to see what happens 3, 4, 5, 10 years down the line, how much of an impact this has on new talent coming out from that part of the world. But nonetheless, I think it's just as important that Zhang keeps this title reign going. I don't think just this one victory is going to do as much as the UFC is hoping. I think a prolonged title reign would be massive for her and, of course, building the sport in China. And it's not going to be very easy. There has been championship turnover in this weight class for the past few years. Zhang, the fifth fighter to hold that UFC strawweight belt, and the challenges aren't going to be easy for her. I assume the next person up will likely be Tatiana Suarez, an undefeated fighter who seems like she could have the perfect recipe for challenging Zhang's style. We haven't seen a ton of her off her back in terms of having to defend against a strong wrestler, and that's what Suarez is all about. I think she has one of the most compelling, not only personal stories, but fighting styles for this weight class. I think in her last win, she was slightly exposed in terms of her striking ability not being at the top tier, but she's, of course, getting better, and will bring a very interesting and unique challenge to Zhang that she hasn't quite faced before. I think that is the fight to make. There's, of course, other names out there like Rose Namajunas, Joanna Jędrzejczyk, and Michelle Waterson are scheduled to fight not long from now, but I think right now Suarez is probably that most deserving contender and another person that could be a huge, impactful champion for the UFC considering her background and everything she's been through. Zhang is wanting to be very active as a champion. She wants to compete often, and I think if Suarez is healthy coming off some of the neck issues she had stemming from her last bout, that would be the perfect matchup for the UFC to make, perhaps even this year, if not early part of 2020.